Officials of the Microfinance Support Center appeared before the Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, to respond to queries raised by the Auditor General's report for the year that ended June 2022. Among them was failure to utilize 21.2 billion shillings, which was meant for on-lending and Emyoga seed capital grants, which affected government from achieving planned milestones.
That money, I thought you wanted the money, because failure to spend the money actually means that you are denying other sectors who are breeding to have to do service delivery the opportunity to give services to our people.
Looking at the comments of the Auditor General, it talks about your failure to utilize the funds being negative in terms of the planned achievements. Now, what efforts have you put in place to ensure that the intended beneficiaries actually receive this money going forward?
We receive the funds, but the process of implementation is long. We go outside there, sensitize the community, identify these circles, and most of these circles at different levels of readiness.
The committee also took interest in the unhealthy loan portfolio of the Microfinance Support Center, which is attributed to weakness in loan appraisals and laxity of undertaking enforcement actions against defaulters. The entity is grappling with 146.1 billion shillings unrecovered debts from borrowers.
When you move to 2.2 and then A, there's something again captured there. Loans worth 4.1 billion were disbursed without carrying out proper loan appraisals. That's A, the last statement there. Loans worth 4.1 billion were disbursed without carrying out proper loan appraisals.
There are groups that are active, they are saving, they are taking loans, but you find that their record system is manual and still weak. So that's why our package has also training. So these are the inconsistencies the auditor is talking about here. So the appraisals are there, but you find the submissions that we are getting from these clients, they have some gaps.
It was established that the entity disbursed 3.7 billion shillings to several clients who lacked vital documents, while a 1.3 billion shillings loan was disbursed to companies without collateral to back the loans as provided for the credit policy.
To my recollection, of evading security is a legal requirement. If a loan so require a security, and being a legal requirement, in other known of loans, there are other eventual processes like mortgaging, because a security is not just brought for custody.
Of this, say 4.1 billion, the ED cannot say, for one, there was incompetent employees that they probably recruited. It means even the ED is incompetent.
The committee also queried the Microfinance Support Center on how 2 billion shillings was disbursed to Kasolo Foundation Limited, an organization headed by the Minister of State in charge of microfinance, Haruna Cheyune Kasolo.
I do confirm this Kasolo Foundation Limited, which you people gave 2 billion shillings, does it belong to the Honorable Haruna Kasolo, the Minister of State for Microfinance, which supervises your entity, Microfinance Support Center?
This Kasolo Foundation, we gave money to the groups within the foundation.
Who owns Kasolo Foundation?
Kasolo Foundation is owned by groups.
No.
Who are the directors?
Okay, who are the directors of Kasolo Foundation?
Maybe I need to check. I need to check on the record.
On the record, whether the Kasolo Foundation they're talking about is the Kasolo of our own, or is a different Kasolo. Instead of torturing a gentleman who looks to be innocent.
Okay, so two things.
Let the ED
You're actually out of order, Honorable, to say we are torturing anyone.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.